Welcome back to Wireless Productions. This, ladies and gentlemen, is our closing 20-inch drill press setup. This particular model is run by a variable frequency drive and is one of closing's EVS units, electronic variable speed. We needed this drill press for the shop to drill precision holes and chose closing because they're one of the last few manufacturers that make drill presses that are made in USA. Although this unit is very expensive, the cost is minimal when spread over its many decades of service. We also have accessories in order to use the drill press effectively and safely. The design of closing drill presses haven't changed much over the years, and that's a good thing, because why change what works? I honestly don't like the color scheme though, as I think that older closings are painted in better colors of blue or gray. This control panel is what's different on the EVS models. The VFD allows you to run on single phase power with a finer degree of control of drill speed. Here are some close-ups of the various safety decals and maintenance labels found throughout the drill press. The drill press is powered by a 1.5 horsepower 230 volt three-phase electric motor at 60 Hz. The electric motor is built by Balder Reliance and has a maximum of 1760 RPMs. While it says 115 volts, it really runs on 220. The drill press arrives without a plug, so you have to get your own plug and wire that in. The column itself is hollowed out 4 inches in diameter and 66 inches in length. You can see behind the mesh top belt guard closing's heavy duty drive, 3 V belts and a cog belt, delivering positive full power to the spindle at all speeds. This differs from regular closing drill presses, which have a standard Reeves drive. Here's the model number on the nameplate. The VFD is encased in this white box to the right of the unit. This is the thread adjustable depth stop. The quill has 6.5 inches of travel. Here's a quill lock. Here's a telescopic spindle guard. We also have a Heinrich 6PA Gripmaster vise. This version is the pumping action, which adds up to 350 pounds of holding pressure against the locking jaw to the work. This is really useful for wood, plastic, and other compressible materials. The drill press comes with a 22 by 19.5 inch adjustable table with 1/2 inch T-slots and 9-inch centers. I also made my own 1/2 inch T-bolts. These are needed to lock the drill press vise onto the table. You'll also need a brush for metal chips, a wrench, and a drill press drift key. Once plugged in and powered on, you can see the drill press come to life. Safety is paramount and always use a set of glasses to protect your eyes.
I had left the spindle guard up on purpose so that I can film the drilling sequence much better. The drill steps are pretty straightforward. Clamp down your work, tighten down the vise and lock the table. Lock down your drill bit. Set the drill speed. Apply a steady, smooth pressure to the quill. Don't force anything, as you're letting the drill do its job. Drill down until you push through the material. When drilling anything, always use a vise. Never drill work freehanded, as it's extremely dangerous. The work has a likely possibility to slip from your hands and get stuck on the drill bit, which causes it to spin uncontrollably. This can cause serious injuries and will quickly ruin your day. At high enough drill speeds, it's a good chance that the work could fly off and hit someone, or even eviscerate you. The drill press vise is there to make it safer to drill. Always lock it down and use a spindle guard to prevent chips from flying about. In this sequence, I actually missed a step and forgot to lock down the table. You can see the table shift as I drill through the work. A drill press is one of the most dangerous machines that you will ever use. Always treat it with respect. Here's a nice shot of the control panel. You see the emergency stop, forward and reverse switch, and the reset button. From around 90 RPM, I slowly ramp the drill speed up much higher. Although I've never taken it that far, this drill press is supposed to go up to 2000 RPM. But with the mild steel I usually drill, you don't really need to go that high. I only took the drill press up to 1400 RPM, so I'm not going to stress it out. Here I am ramping it back down. I do love the fact that the drill press goes as slow as 40 RPM. In an emergency, just hit the E-stop. The drill trucks we use are the Albrecht Classic Plus Keyless with a 3-Morse taper integral shank. The one currently installed is the 1/32 to 1/2 inch. It's a very nice, precise, accurate chuck that's made in Germany. The steps to remove the chuck are very simple. All you need is your drift key and a hammer. I lock the quill down to its lower position and put something soft under the chuck to catch it when it releases. A folded rag will do the job. A few taps of the hammer and the chuck should release quite easily. With the quill lowered and locked, it prevents the chuck from falling over. We also have the bigger 1/8 to 5/8 drill chuck as well. Here's a good shot of the size difference between the two. Although the 1/2 inch chuck will handle most drill bits, the 5/8 is really useful for the larger sizes. When installing the chuck, we need to make sure that the 3-Morse taper is extremely clean. The first step is to make sure that the jaws are retracted all the way back. Make sure the center of the spindle is cleaned up inside of it as well. You're going to need a block of wood or something soft to help with the install. I slide the 5/8 chuck and make sure the tang is oriented into the slot. One or two quick hard smacks to the block of wood is all it takes to install the drill chuck. The two levers on the back of the table allow it to go down and elevate, as well as turn from side to side. It's always important to lock things down to make sure your work doesn't move. Here I set up a black marker to show the outline of where the spindle meets the table. This also shows the pattern of when you're not careful and drill through the table. You end up making a smile of shame. In order to prevent that, I use these two steel plates to protect the table. I've seen too many pictures of disfigured tables from careless users. I'm going to do my best to prevent that from happening. The other thing you're going to need is a good set of drill bits. We got ours from Norseman and Cleanline, which are good made in USA drill bits. I also got this 115 piece jobber set, which is a good starter set and is full of English sizes. This Norseman set comes with sharp drill bits that hold their edge, especially when you use the slow speeds of the drill press. I even got the number 2 center drill for it, which isn't included in the set. Lastly, I got a couple of Irwin drill bits that I use and abuse for general use. You'll be able to accomplish a lot with all these accessories. Our drill press is bolted onto our industrial heavy-duty steel pallet. This adds another 150 pounds to the drill press's 620 pounds, making it very difficult to topple over. Yet, with any pallet jack, our indestructible steel pallets are easily moved around the shop. These two bolts on the side of the drill press hold the assembly up on the column. Unless you want the drill press to drop on your foot, don't mess with these. Well, that's it from us. We're Rouse Productions. Catch you guys later.